I always wanted to build a screen that can be lifted up and down, and recently I had the opportunity to build one. So I did some research on the internet and I found nothing. So I had to start from scratch and I came up with this system. So the system is based on an Arduino Nano. I put it in a small box in here. Just have to push the button. So two servo motors, a regular servo motor, a big one for the spool. I customized it for the continuous rotation and a small one for the lock. There is also a night light here for my kid and a control temperature control of my stuff in here. So there is a temperature sensor inside, and when the temperature rises it makes the two fans here moving. Okay, so you will explain the problems I had when I built this and how I managed to figure out some of those problems. So first of all, I have to face a problem that the screen will touch the top of this furniture. So I had to build, to design some kind of wheel to make it slide on here. So I used those metallic parts on a screw. Also a micro switch. The lower micro switch, and there is also, of course, in the upper position, another micro switch. Don't know if I can. Okay. This wooden part will hit the switch in the lower position and it will make the screen stop. Okay, for the spool, I had to face another problem. Okay, so the screen is about 3 or 4 kilograms, so it's quite heavy actually. So I had to design a brake. To design the spool, I used as a base the regular horn from the servo motor and I bound it to this stuff like this with some pinion on here. And with this master model, I built a silicone mold. Actually, it's my job, I'm a prototype builder, so it wasn't a big deal for me. Okay. And I vacuum cast the spool with a resin, thermoset resin, so that the first one, the very first one I made, but the pinion gear were way too thin, so when the stopper hits it in the upper position, it make it break. Okay, so the second stopper I made has two teeth. It was better, but still not enough. So the one I use now has three teeth. When I designed this spool, I had to be very careful about one thing. It's to have exactly the same space here and here on the two parts of the spool. Why? Because if you don't have the same space, that means that the cable won't rise at the same rate speed on the left and the right. It's a very, very bad thing. So I had to be very, very careful in measuring the distance. my 3-year-old kid sleep in this room, so I had to build a nightlight with auto-off function. So I put the LED tape on here, and you can control the light with a regular potentiometer here. And to choose the timer, there is actually 4 timers. Pushing, keep push the lower switch of the screen and just turn the potentiometer, and there is four series of flashes. So one flash is for 15 minutes, two flashes for 13 minutes, three flashes for 1 hour, so you get the idea. Okay, so before starting with the code, you will have to understand two things. The first one is, if you want to control the speed of your regular computer fan, you will have to increase the PWM frequency. The native Arduino PWM frequency is about 500 Hz, so 0.5 kHz. You can eventually control the fan, but it will emit a very annoying sound, like a loudspeaker. So you don't want this, trust me. So you have to increase the speed of the PWM frequency. So you can do this. You just have to add this line to your code in the setup and you're done. The second thing is the analog write resolution if you want to use a very dim light. At 255 levels, that is the default setting, the gap between the first levels are perceived by the human eye to be quite huge, actually. And if you dim the light gradually down to zero, it won't be smooth. So there is a library to change it. It's called the PWM library here. And you just have to add this line in your setup to change the resolution of the timer 1 and 2 related pins. And with this, instead of 255 levels, you will have 30,000 levels. A lot of automated functions such as delay relies on timer 0, so this function lets timer 0 at its default values. The drawback is you cannot use timer 1 or 2 related method anymore. That includes libraries. So that means no servo motor library. But no problem, there is a way to control servo with a regular function without the servo library. I will show you. So you have to understand how works a servo motor. A servo motor is waiting for a pulse every 10 milliseconds. The longer the pulse, the greater the angle will be. So your main loop has to be about 10 milliseconds long. I suppose it depends on the maker of the servo motor, but for mine it worked well down to 8 milliseconds, and I don't know for the upper limit, but I think it should be fine up to about 20 milliseconds. But I can't assure you. You have to try. To make it simple, forget the delays when the servo motors are moving, and cut the servo power with a relay or a transistor when you are done is a good thing to do. I won't explain everything in the code, only the big lines. For example, the running median library here is used to smooth the readings of the analog temperature sensor. The wire is about 1.5 meter long, so this kind of sensor is very sensitive to electronical noise. So to limit it, first use a shielded cable, may help a lot. You can also add a capacitor and a resistor near the sensor. The last thing is, if possible, don't put the sensor or the cable close to a PWM noise emitting device. Can be hard. But of course the best choice you can do is, instead of an analog sensor, use a digital one. Those are not so sensitive to electrical noise. I should have done with this kind of sensor, actually. I regret that. That is the function that controls the light. The first part is to reset the countdown of the timer every time you touch the potentiometer. I use the threshold to avoid self-reset in the case of you want to use a cheap potentiometer, and they are not very stable, so a threshold may be a good thing. To have a smooth dimming, I made this formula to slow down the decrease speed of the value. Huge number decrease very fast, but when you get close to zero, it will slow down. I'm quite happy with this. Okay, this function is for the choice of the timer. When the screen is in the upper position, you just have to keep pushed the screen lower switch and choose the timer you want with the potentiometer. A flashing sequence will give you a feedback. One flash for 15 minutes, two flashes for 30 minutes, etc. The code that makes the screen moving is based on a switch case. And to avoid delay, I used timestamps. When the state of the screen changes from moving to not moving, for example, the servo timestamp will reset in here. So to make things happen exactly when I want and in the order I want, I just have to count the time with milli, the function milli, and compare it to what I want. So for example, here after 300 milliseconds, this will happen, and after 325 milliseconds, this, and so on. So I don't think that my code is a piece of art or something. Actually, I'm quite a newbie. I started Arduino and programming in general about 2 months ago. So I'm completely newbie, but with some help in the internet, you can do actually great things. Arduino is a very powerful tool, and even someone with absolutely no background in programming can do such kind of thing very easily. So, small bonus for the end. This is the way I can increase by about 50 centimeters the distance from the projector to the screen. The image is reflected by a mirror hung by a regular suction cup camera stand. So I take off the suction cup and I put a screw inside it, and the image is perfectly reflected to the screen.